Six String Corner, and today I'm going to give you the Rush classic Xanadu. Yes, the song that goes on and on and on and on. And we're going to cover it here today. I'm going to show you all the parts, and so you can just go ahead and run with it and have a lot of fun with this really iconic Rush tune. And for a song like this, you're going to need to take your fingers to the gym. Make sure that they're warmed up and they're ready to go. I have a series of exercises in guitar finger gymnastics, which is right below. It's a free set of videos that you can download and take wherever you want. Choose whichever one you want, whether you want finger coordination, strength, dexterity. It's all in there, guitar finger gymnastics, right in the link below. Okay, so for this song, I'm going to be showing you more than telling you, so I'm going to call out some key points, and some points in this video we're going to slow down so you can really catch it. This first one here is going to be the intro. There's like three sections of intro, so I'm going to call them part A, B, and C. Part A is a lot of swells that you're going to definitely going to want to use that volume pedal as much as you can, Alex does. So here we go. Let's get started with it. Now, bear in mind that there's going to be a lot of improvisation that you can do with harmonics and things like that, as long as you're creating stuff like that, as long as you're using that volume swell. But I'm gonna give you the key parts to this part A that you're gonna definitely need to know. All right, so here we go. Both of those are on the low strings, the low E and A string, on 7, 9, and 7 on each of those two strings. I like putting a little bit of this from Exit Stage Left. Kick on a little gain. Right, I close that out with an A chord. Just a really quick note here, this is all here in the ninth position. So if you can see this right here, okay, it's basically an E major. Those are the notes I'm using. All of them, but it's in sevens. 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and it starts again. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, this is part C of the intro. This basically revolves around this E major chord. All right, so what I'm gonna do for you here is I'm going to take the delay and reverb. I'm going to really clean this up. Normally you're going to have a little bit of gain on there, but I want to kind of show you exactly how I'm playing this so you have a feel for it. So very low on the E and then high. So low strings, high string. Or you can do down. Either way, as long as you get to a low to a high on that E major chord. And then here's the riff. You do that three times, okay? And then what you're going to do is take that same scale and you're just going to walk it down. This next part of the intro, it's really playing major bar chords, but you're not playing the bar chord. You're just playing the middle four strings, this shape right here. They call it the E major shape, if that's what you're used to. This is a bar chord that has the root note on the low E. The thing is we're not going to play the low E or the high E. We're going to play the middle four strings, so you don't have to bar it. You just arrange the fingers. You just change them such that you can play it like this. It's kind of like if you played that F chord and you just did the little finger here and then brought the ring finger here and then bring your finger up here to bar it. So it's a little bit easier to play than that, the bar chord. This is basically what revolves around the strumming. Fast drum in there. There's a lot of that going in. That goes four times, and the fourth time you just want to sort of open it up a little bit. A little bit less staccato on the first three chords. And then when you get to this A, you're going to take your pointer finger off and you're going to go to the A. I call it the A position if we were doing an A bar chord. G, F sharp, and then E major. So this next part that I'm starting out here, it's really just using this E major shape that's going to fly around on the same strings. Not fly around, it's going to slide around on the strings here. And you're going to have this basic arpeggio pattern. And then pick the last four. And then later, you go up to the B, what would be the B if it was a B bar chord? A. All right, and then what we do, we kick on a little bit of overdrive, but we're just going to go now to power chords. G, A, and stop. All right, now this next part is where the singing comes in. We can call this the verse. It starts off with just power chords from E, G, A, and B, and then it's going to go to the bar chords, the full out major chord. They're all majors here, E, B, A, and G. All right, so it's going to be like this. All right, that's just the power chords. Now, watch when you start the power chord and we're going to the bar chord. See what we're doing there? A little bit faster, but you see how I'm playing that, and then you repeat it again. And then you're going to play that whole section again. Go again, you're going to go. Stay in the bar chords. Power. Drum roll, stop. Then it's going to be E power chord, G power chord, and then we're going to go into the next section. And on the word do, we're going to come into the next section here. Now this next section is an arpeggiated pattern. It starts on D. All right. So I'm going to slow this video down a little bit here, and you can kind of watch how I'm picking this. It's D, and then I don't know what the name of this is, but it's you're on the B flat here. Keep the little finger on the D note and open G. Then a C, open G, and the D. And then this little part, open G to the 4th, 2nd, and open frets on the D string. All right, so here's how it goes. Now watch the dynamics in something like this too, because it starts out kind of quiet and then it'll build. What I do live is towards the end of that, I kick on a little bit of overdrive. Not a lot, you don't get too excessive, but you want it to be a little more power sounding. And it just said, I have dying on 22. Okay, at the end of the first time, it's times on the D chord, and we go right back to the D section, which comes into the next verse. And then you basically going to repeat this whole thing again until you get to this same part for I Have Down in Honeydew. And what's going to happen here, or actually it's going to be after I Have Drunk the Milk of Paradise. And then at this very last part, is the G, F sharp, open E on the low E string. And then you're going to go back to that intro, the D section, two times. Remember, that's the E shape. We're going from the literally the E major chord and sliding this up into what would be like the F sharp major position, but the open B and the open E are hanging in there. So you do that twice, then the next two times, we kind of follow along with the drums. All right, and that takes us into the guitar solo. The beginning of the solo starts on an open E. Sort of bends its way into the F sharp. Now, to me, actually, this is best done with a vibrato bar. You can sort of just kind of bring it up. I don't have one here, so in this guitar. So what you can just simply do is open E and just sort of do a slide, intentional slide there into the F sharp twice. All right, now we're going to jump way up here into the 12th position. Now, mind you that this song is in quote-unquote E, but especially in the solo, a lot of this, a lot of the scale, not all of it, but most of it falls in not the E major, but it's more playing like a, I don't know what to call it, like an E Dorian, because it feels to me like you're playing the D major scale or the B minor, whichever one you want to talk about. But you're focusing on that E rather than the B or the D. So that's what a lot of the solo, not all of it, as you'll see, there's parts in here we do slide back into the E major scale, but just so you're aware of it, so when you start playing some of these notes as you're flying around here, you're gonna see that. So this one starts up here, and I'm just gonna show you how the bends work. It's 15 to 17. And then on 15, bend, those are full tell step bends. Now here we're in the E major, so here we're in the E major zone, so you're right here in the 9th position. And you just come in with a bend on the off the 11th fret. So you're just going to drop down the scale here. Just sort of do a little bend there on the F sharp. Then jump back to your E major. All right, back in that E. And now we're going to jump back up in this sort of E Dorian-ish scale here. And we're going to pull-offs here. few little plucks in there. All right, let me break that down real quick. I'll take that a little slower too. Alright, so some bends right here up on the B string. So you see, we're just kind of dropping down. I don't know if that's exactly what he does. He kind of changes it here and there from shows that I've seen and heard and then from what's on the studio album. But the gist of it is just coming down the scale. Holding down that E. You're hammering on and pulling off. Go up the scale. Alright, and that's just a bend. On the 17th fret on the B string, 17th fret on the E, hammer on pull off. All right, and it ends on that D note. And then that's it. Then you go back to. All right, and then you go back to playing the intro 7/4 riff. On the very end of the song, the bass kind of plays do 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 does that lines. And what I like to do live is I play this little. Alright, we're just playing around with the open B. 12th fret up here. And that's on 16 to 12. Right, and that's over here on the, what is that, the 7th fret. So. All right, and then big ending on the E. Hey, thanks a lot for watching. I hope you got something out of this. This is a great song. It's got a lot of stuff in it, so good luck with it. Hey, if you liked the video, go ahead and please do that right now. Be sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so yet. And I got that one bell there for the notifications. You can go ahead and click that so you get notified for more stuff that's coming up. Rush songs and all kinds of other things guitar related. All right, thanks a lot. Rock on.